Greetings, Twitch, and greetings, YouTube. This is Sean and Etienne from your favorite Lord of the Rings podcast, Cardboard of the Rings. And tonight, we're just going to do a little special since it's just the two of us. What do you say, man?
Sure.
Well, tonight the idea, since we're down a few players and we didn't really have anything planned ahead of time, our third age quests are kind of on hold since Ian is, we haven't been able to plan with him yet. So we thought we'd put it to the chat room and those who decided to be here tonight to see what we play. So let's see who's here.
The delay is 15 seconds, right, for the stream?
Yeah, sounds about right. Yeah. We'll find out. I'm actually also doing another experiment tonight. Hopefully the YouTubers will appreciate it. We're going to try putting the chat window in the recording so you can actually see the magic happen. I don't know if the resolution
I'm actually
upload...
also doing another experiment
for the love
tonight.
Of God. Hopefully the YouTubers will appreciate it. Anyway. So we're going to go ahead and try to have the chat on screen so the YouTube can actually participate. So if anyone's in the chat, say something. Make yourself known. I don't know if we can see current viewers yet. That usually takes a little while to update.
Yeah, mine is loading.
So, Etienne, your innuendo in your story today was something, you know.
We do not sleep.
Oh, was that yours?
That was mine. Yeah, I was.
Hey, Dave's there, Bardley.
One entry per viewer, so I couldn't have possibly done it again.
So did anyone else enjoy the... I don't know why I even decided to put it on there that we should keep it PG-13. You know, I've met Brandon before. And I was basically... I was asking for innuendo. Did anyone else enjoy the Facebook post today? Did anyone follow that thread at all?
Oh, boy.
Oh, the other fun part is the Twitch crowd will actually get to see our delay. So they'll see us responding to them in 15 seconds ago, real time.
Oh, time travel. Such a missed place to be.
We'll have to invent new tenses for tonight.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I don't know if there is an official way to actually put like a poll or anything in the Twitch chat. So in the absence of that, let's just have a quick discussion or start throwing up some quest ideas. Anyone have any quests they'd like to see tackled or yes, it was no surprise that Brian went over the top. I don't know what I expected. But I should have expected that.
You wouldn't have missed the opportunity.
Oh my God. And if you guys had seen, like, when Brandon is prepping for something, he loves to talk about how he's prepping for something. And it's fun because when he does something, he goes for it. But he was talking about his masterpiece. And yeah, then he finally put it out there. Boy, it was something. If you haven't seen it yet, go to the Cardboard of the Rings Facebook page. Check it out. It's pretty funny. And Dave asks how many players tonight. It is just me and Etienne, so we will be, I guess, not two-handing it, but two players.
Yep.
So it looks like we got about eight people out there. I'm not sure how many of you are actually in the chat, so it's possible that we have opinions that can't be voiced, but... Anyone has an inclination. We'll basically take the the first quest that two people can agree on. Ah, I knew someone would say Lake Town.
And we have the veto right to just refuse any quest we don't want to play and then choose our own. That's how our democracy works at COTR.
All right, so the Gen Con quests are quite popular thus far. Yeah, of all two votes. I'd be fine. Lake Town, I'd be fine doing it. I just would not expect us to win because that freaking quest drives me up the wall. Massing, I enjoy.
Massing's fun. Stone of Eric, too.
Yep. I'm hoping the old forest follows suit.
Yep. Oh,
shit. Sounded like you knocked over a wooden sculpture.
Yeah. No, it's the those coasters, you know, when they stick to the glass and then you lift the glass and it just sticks to the bottom and then drops noisily.
And then the coaster itself is glass, so it breaks the glass and then the glass. All right, looks like we have a second for massing at Osgiliath. Let's fire it up.
All right.
Second and third. Okay.
So,
Do you want to run the encounter deck, if you'd be so kind?
Sure. And let's see.
Let's load a deck. All right, and here's another fun one. I've got my big old folder of decks that I keep out here. Of the decks out here, what would you guys like to see played? We'll make it absolute viewer request tonight. What are you packing, Etienne? Maybe that'll help the decision.
I've got Hirluin, Teodred, Barovor. Does that conflict with any of the Euros you expected to play?
Well, I don't know what to expect to play yet.
Okay.
Let's see here. So I suppose maybe a little description of these. So Aragorn and Grima, that's a kind of a straight out of Voice of Isengard Doom Abuse deck. That with two players is playable because we do have Desperate Alliance in there. We've got... Actually, this was a viewer-submitted deck. I'm not quite sure. Brandon put it in there. I guess it's an overpowered Aragorn deck. We've got Brandon's Grief deck. Brandon's April Fool's deck. Aelmer and Crew is kind of a lore tactics hybrid. More of a combat deck. As is Aomer and Imrahil. Orc Catch in Hand is a good solo deck, but I think it would function pretty well against this quest too. It's kind of a nice all-rounder. Then we've got my two Dwarf Swarms. One's a little more threat-focused. This one's kind of the basic. One Awkward Date, kind of meant for... Now, what was that one for? Oh, that one was for the... Fords of Isen specifically. And also we have a mono lore trap deck, and we have a attack into the staging area type deck. I'll take the first request.
First turn questing is going to be a harsh... Maybe I didn't choose a good deck. Oh, well.
Yeah, this one... Charters. All right. Let's see. So we'll go ahead and load this up. Now, this one's kind of meant to be paired with something that keeps stuff in the staging area, so we'll see how it goes. All right.
I've got a prediction on how it's going to go, but I won't say.
Well, That's just all kinds of optimistic of you. All right. So
you know I cheer for the encounter deck.
All right. So this deck rocks Aomer, Dúnhir, and Glorfindel. You know, actually, our threat is probably not too bad. I think this might actually function as long as we can get through these first couple turns.
Cool.
All right. So we'll go ahead and get started here. So Etienne has put one of each of the three scouts, the Owain Riders, Wolves from Mordor, and Snaga scouts, into the staging area. Witch King's out of play. And shuffle the other scouts back into the deck. How are you liking your hand, sir?
It's fine. I'll keep it.
I think I like mine too. I would like to see a Light of Valinor, but I also don't want to chuck my spear away because that's pretty huge. Yeah, and I could get a really good combo off that first turn. Very good combo off that first turn. Yeah, I'm going to keep it. I'm going to keep it.
Okay. I'll do Control N.
Nope, sorry, that's me.
Do I have to do it again?
Yeah,
There we
you
go.
should. Yep.
Okay, let's
All right.
roll. Good luck. One, two. I'll spend. Kind of a waste, but I'll spend one for one of those, one for one of those, and one for one of those. Go ahead.
All snowboard scouts and no locations, huh?
Well, we'll need some chum blockers.
Yes,
You'll
we
thank
sure
me
will.
later.
I know. All right. Now the real question is I suppose we'll do this. We'll pay one for a Westfold horse breeder. Look at the top 10 of my deck. Hopefully find a mount. Oh, hey there, buddy. Also, my Light of Valinor was three cards away from the top. Hate to see it. Hopefully we'll find that again. I feel like I want to keep all of that. Now, I could snag one of those Snaga Scouts straight away here and just get rid of it, but I'm not sure that it's worth doing it on that because they're pretty wimpy. Yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and pay one tactics resource and put a Spear of the Mark on Dune here.
Okay.
And that's it for me.
I'll send a Weenie 4 to the quest, give a resource to Barovor.
Yeah, we kind of got to go balls to the wall here. and not many balls can be walled. Good Lord. All right, I'll send Glorfindel, and since I don't have light, he adds one to my threat. And I'll send the horse breeder as well. So I'm sending a total of four.
All right, first card.
Hey, that's what I like to see.
So we're
So,
sending 10 now
yeah.
and 1.2. If they have crossed the Anduin, we have not. And 2.0,
All right.
2.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 against 10. So we raise our threat by 2,
Hang
which
on.
is. Oh.
I'm gonna give Barovor plus one willpower, and I'll lower my threat by three.
Okay, so we raise our tread by 1.
All right. That could have gone much worse.
Yep.
Perfect.
So I think I'll just stack those like this. It's going to be easier.
That works.
I'll optionally engage a wolf from Mordor.
Now hang on, the both the Snaga Scouts come down to me.
Okay.
All
Okay.
right.
And
Think beyond
I'll.
that, do we have anything else that needs to come down? Oh, the wolves from Mordor are going to come down
Yeah,
too.
the second one's gonna engage me as well.
Can you handle that?
The first player, that's me actually, so that guy should be here. Well, yeah, I mean the snowborn scouts are gonna die and the walls are gonna be reshuffled, right? So
Oh, yeah, that's probably a good way to go.
yeah. The shadow effect is pretty devastating, but yeah, that's the best way to get rid of them.
Fair enough.
Okay, shadows. Let's go with this one. Me again.
Wait, hang on, hang on. Do it in
Whoops.
Andrew's voice.
Oh man, I don't know. Me again.
What? Me again?
Yeah, okay. I can't do voices. I'm terrible at it.
So
And
I'm going to
this.
continue to make you do them for the rest of this
Yeah.
episode. All right, so the other one there, no shadow effect. So they both
And
killed something, and as part of their force, they shuffle them back into the encounter deck. All right, my first one, I'm going to take undefended and see how we go. So, all right. So I'll put one wound undefended on Glorfindel. I'm going to chance this other one too. All right, so one wound. We'll put it on Glorfindel.
Whoops.
It's all right. That's where they're about to end up. All right, so then I'll attack one of them with Éomer, and he has a strength 5 because people left play. He dies. Now, I will declare Dune here
Yeah.
as oh, nope, as an attacker against one of these guys
Sweet.
to kill it.
Ain't that the best way to get rid of those bastards?
Oh yeah, Dune here. Like, I don't know. Did you have a favorite hero out of the core set? Like, I don't have a favorite sphere, but I did back then, and it was Spirit simply for Dune here.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad he's back in the fold now with all the Rohan play, all the Rohan love. All right,
Twas a
so
long time coming, though.
yeah, that's just so true. He became obsolete quickly and stayed that way for a long time. All right, any refresh actions?
Nope.
Fantastic. Let's do it.
Do I have to do it again? Yep.
Right, I feel like I feel like I should have more tactics resources. That's what I feel like. Okay. I'll pay one for a Rohan Warhorse on Dune here. And I'll pay one for another horse breeder. And I'll go ahead and look at the top 10. You go ahead and plan.
I'll spend 2 leadership resources for Steward of Gondor. I'll put it on Hirluin. Put 2 resources.
Oh yeah, Outlands is going.
Could you use a resource out of on one of your noble characters?
Éomer would love a resource, and you'll see why.
Okay, there's one going towards him.
Yes,
I
Dave,
just
Dune here. Dune here gets +3 when he attacks alone to the staging area, and then the Spear of the Mark gives him +1 attack or +2 if he's attacking an enemy in the staging area. So he is a total of 5 against enemies in the staging area. Yes, and I would say it fits best on him. Though if you're playing, I guess 4th Eorlingus could also, it could make people benefit from there, but yeah. All right, and then I also played the Rohan Warhorse on Dune here. Which, after he participates in an attack that destroys an enemy, I get to exhaust the horse to ready him. So,
Oh,
pulling double duty.
I know 2 dead wing riders.
Yeah, pretty much. So, I'm sorry, did you say I could take a resource on Éomer?
Yeah, because of the envoy who's
Fantastic.
sharing the love.
So, watch this action before we even quest.
Oh, a quick strike, quick strike. No.
So, I'm gonna play Quick Strike. And exhaust character I control to declare it as an attacker and immediate resolve. It's attacking against any eligible enemy. Things in the staging area are eligible for Dune here, so he will attack and kill a Wayne Rider.
Those Wind Raiders didn't see those cards coming
And then
1 year and a
I'll,
half in the future.
no doubt, I'll exhaust the Warhorse. And he gets to ready. So thanks for that resource. But
Welcome.
no, I only killed the one of them.
Oh, right, it's 1 attack. Duh. Okay. Are we ready to quest?
Oh, I'd say so.
Okay, you're going to come.
So I suppose I'll go 4 again and raise my threat by 1 for Glorfindel.
So that's 4.
Yes, and Sean the Bomb, who has an awesome sign-in name, by the way. As soon as I get a second spear, that's exactly where it's going. Straight on Dune here.
But he already has 2 restricted attachments.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Well, I think for an older quest with lower defense and hit points, he does fine with the one, but I've certainly put two on him because he gets huge.
Mm-hmm. I'll send... We're facing four. I'm trying to remember the treacheries in this quest. There's one that discards ally from your hand.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that one, I don't think they are too bad. I'll send...
Cut off is the main one I remember.
Yeah. So I'll commit Theodred for sure, and I'll give you a resource somewhere.
Woohoo!
Well, I guess it would be Glorfindel.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'll send another 1, 2, 3. Four, five. So we're at 10.
That'll work.
Okay. First one. Oh, they don't scare me anymore. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Unless you have some action.
I do not.
Okay. Do we want to go to the Morgulduin? It's pretty nasty. Maybe we shouldn't.
While it's active, when a chimera can deal one damage to the character, God, Legolas would be lovely now.
I've got a healer coming up maybe next. Oh, no. Next turn.
And right now we can't go to West Bank, so we could go here. We can't go to it later, but it's only one threat. Ugh. That one is...
I've got a healer next turn, so...
You do? Okay, then let's do it.
Yeah.
Might as well, since there's not another.
Yeah. Okay. And engagement, I'll pass.
I'm going to be able to take out another Wainrider. So, yeah. I'll pass as well.
Okay. I'll draw myself.
Or should I... I could get some damage on the Vanguard, at least. He's going to get a lot bigger once we cross.
Yeah, but I think the Wainriders are the priority, just because we can't get rid of them so easily right now.
All right, fair enough.
Yeah.
We'll wait till we get more locations out there. All right, so...
And even if the Orc Vanguard is nasty, he's probably not going to engage us.
True.
Yeah. I don't know. Okay. So I'll play a Darren's Runes. Draw two. And discard one.
Sean the Bomb asks if there are any weapon attachments that aren't restricted besides Rivendell Bow. I think that's the only one. That's the only one I can think of. And Dave Gilligan just fact checked it, so I'll believe it.
Okay.
We also remember that Celebrian Stone is restricted, so, which is interesting.
Mm.
All right, go ahead and give me a shadow for my scout here.
I guess the Celebrian Stone is one big rock.
So instead of carrying it around your neck, you've got to carry it.
Yeah, it's a boulder with a little wagon with wheels you've got to carry around.
All right, I think I'm going to risk it undefended again.
Gutsy.
Uh-oh. Yeah, all right. So he gets plus one, so he's two. I suppose you're going to have a healer next turn?
Yeah.
All right, I'll go ahead and pop one on Dune here. All right. So you have no error. So for my attacks, then I will swing with Aomer to do three attack. He dies. Then I'll swing with Dune here against one of the Wainriders.
Perfect. Let's refresh.
Hey, speak of the devil.
Okay, I'll trigger Steward of Gondor. I'll draw myself two cards. I'll spend one leadership resource for a errant rider. I'll exhaust him to transfer a resource to Berevor. put a healer down,
yeah,
and put an Aether swordsman down.
Good call. All right, now let me ask the room. Now YouTube is probably going to be a different issue, but with the chat over here, is anyone having any greater issues than they had before seeing the table? It's taking up a full fifth of the screen, but I'm hoping it's helpful in some way. But if it's preventing, you know, the useful viewing of the playing area, then that's kind of defeating the purpose. So let me know if it is. Oh, and Dave called me out. Yep, I forgot the attack boost when I did the undefended damage, so Dune hears that too. All right.
I'm done.
You're done? I suppose. We'll pop a Dagger of Westerness on Aylmer. And Tengama says it would be a pain for 3+ players, and that's a fair point. It's a normal pain for 3+ players.
Yeah.
God,
the first turn is awful.
Well, I think he means the chat window. Having the chat window in the stream.
Okay, I thought you meant the scenario.
Yeah, well, and the problem is, I mean, some of these quests just get so crazy with things staying in play, and God, that last, like a whole, basically the whole campaign where we were playing 4 players,
yeah,
the board just got so ridiculous. But yeah, we'll definitely be conscious of it. I think it's nice to have it over here for the YouTubers at least. Anyway, I am done playing, so you go ahead.
Okay, let's send 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Eight, and I'll give a resource to Barovor. No, I can't. To himself, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, I'll send 8.
All right. I will go with my precedented 4. And increase my threat by 1.
All right. I'll reveal the first card, a little scout. And if the players have crossed the end when we have not, so that's pretty mundane. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And we have forgotten the damage.
Oh.
From this.
It's after a character commits?
Oh, yeah.
Crap.
So
we would have done things differently. Hang on.
Well, you wouldn't have sent your horse breeder, that's for
right,
sure.
And you wouldn't have sent any of your allies.
Well, Dan Flasser's min gives plus 1.
Oh, he does.
So.
Okay, so we lose 1. All right, and again, that's the active location. Whenever a character commits to a quest, deal damage to it.
Yeah. So we put 2 on the quest, 3 on the location, and 6 threat for a total of 11.
All right.
And that's a West Bank location we got there, so we cannot travel to it at this point. I'll trigger my Warden of Healing now, just in case things go south.
Sure.
And did Glorfindel get a damage for committing?
He did not.
Okay. So.
No, wait, he did. He only had 1 on him before. Did he?
Okay.
I don't know. Maybe. I lost track. I thought I put it on him.
Okay. It's possible. So you would have 1 less?
Nope. I'm a damn liar. Okay. So you heal him?
So I wonder if the ranger would be a first target. Maybe not. I think I'll heal this guy first. And Glorfindel?
That works. All right, Dave asks if we've got any card draw on these decks other than Barovor. I'm rocking a couple Ancient Mathem and a full set of Foe Hammers, but we'll see if I see them.
I've got Darren's runes and peace and tot, so.
Problem is with card draws, you have to draw into it.
Yeah. Okay, so he's exhausted, and let's engage.
Let's travel to the captured watchtower, I think.
It's a West Bank location.
So it is. Never mind.
Yeah. I could take the scout.
The Snaga scouts are going to come down to me anyway.
Oh.
Because I'm still lower threat. Hey, buddy.
Okay, I won't engage anybody then.
If I do, I will take the Vanguard. No. Yeah. Damn it. So if I do that. Yeah, I think I can kill everyone I need to. Yep, we'll take the Vanguard. Watch this magic. Rohan!
Actually, were you keeping the Wayne Rider for done here?
I am.
Okay.
Hence the Rohan!
Right. So, shadow cards in order.
Alright, I should probably... Yeah, I'm going to risk the Snaga Scout undefended one more time. We're going to play it fast and loose tonight. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Let's discard an ally card from his... Oh, thank God I have one. All right, so I have to discard an ally card from my hand or the attacking enemy would get plus three attack.
Two allies instead if undefended.
Oh, son of a... Well, there's fast and loose for you. God dang it. Yeah, and you don't have any card draw to give me with Barovor, do you? I only have the one ally in my hand. That's unfortunate.
Oh, there's an action window? Usually?
Maybe. Probably not. All right, well, here's how it's going to happen. So I think I have to, even if I can't discard two, I still have to partially fulfill. So I'll discard my one. And then he's a four, so I'll put four damage on Glorfindel, since I think you're going to pick up the rest of the willpower.
Yeah.
And I don't have my Light of Valinor out, so all it's doing is increasing my threat. Boo, 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 boo.
And my Warden of Healing is unhappy. You work so hard getting back to health.
Oh, well,
and he gets backstabbed by that little bastard goblin. Or it's actually an orc. It's
not I feel really silly now because I have my little chump blockers back here that I could have easily defended with.
Yeah. Well, they would have died, right?
Yeah.
But yeah.
Anyway. Sean the Bomb asks, if this quest is still hard with the current cool player cards, I'd say it's certainly gotten easier. But if you're stupid, you know, like I just was, it can certainly bite you in the ass. All right, anyway, then I'll defend the Uruk with one of my chump blockers.
All right. Oh, shit.
Oh, for the... All right, well, at least I can take two undefended. All right, yeah. So Shadow has dealt two damage to the defending character, which kills it, which means it's undefended. So now I take two undefended damage. Good lord. All right, well, at least this is going to make it worth it. It's gonna
in my head, he had five attacks. So I thought you had less than a third character.
Oh, God. This would have turned into a solo quest pretty quickly.
Yeah. So much easier for me.
All right. Attacking back.
Hirlewin wants to contribute.
All right. Fair enough. So Aomer will swing in for... So he's five plus because of his buff, and then he's another two, so seven against the Uruk Vanguard. And then is Hirlewin, is he still a one?
He's a one.
Okay. So then Dune here will help as well.
Okay.
Oop. Cockeyed Dune here. How is that? Anyway. All right. Whoop. Uh-oh, my octagon's failing. Oh, okay, we're good. Okay, so he dies. The Rohan Warhorse readies because he killed someone. You know what? I take that back. Aomer is not going to attack. Dune here will. I'm going to play Unseen Strike to give him plus three. Ooh. So he's... That still would have been enough, right?
three, four, five, six. No.
All right.
Oh, wait. Three, four, five, six, seven till we needed nine.
All right, never mind.
Yeah.
So Dune here readies with the War Horse. I thought I was going to be able to get that scout again this turn, but
yeah.
What are you going to do? I'll take another undefended to turn next turn. Anyway, so then Dune here will attack against the Wayne Rider in the staging area for five attack to key it.
All right. Refresh.
Yaza.
I'll go control N.
So I know you're still kind of setting up, but if you happen to be set for card draw, it would be
I can give you two cards. You need it?
I kind of do.
Go ahead.
Thank you.
It's so easy to be selfish at this game. I love it.
Well, I'm just so used to having to play with Brandon and actually have to present a case for why he should help me first.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. I want to keep an ally in my hand in case we get cut off again.
Right.
So, but I kind of need the chump. If we get cut off as a treachery, I can cancel it. So I'm going to pay one and put down a Knights of the Swan. Go ahead.
What do you think you're doing? Those are my guys. I'll spend one from Theodred for a Sword of Morthon, and let's give it to Theodred. No, to a Gondor ally. What am I doing? I'm totally cheating.
You can do the Envoy or the Eren Rider. Or the healer.
It's kind of a question of whether the Eren Rider I'll be using. Do you need resources right now?
Well, yeah, they wouldn't hurt. There's nothing I need to play immediately that I can't pay for.
Yeah, I'll give it to the Envoy, and I'll pass along one resource from Heroine to any one of your heroes.
Woohoo!
Okay. And that's it for me.
All right. I'll quest for one.
Mm-hmm. And your contribution is appreciated.
Don't patronize me.
I'll exhaust the warden to heal those two guys. And I'll send 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Eight, nine. So that's a total of 10. And I'll send Theodred as well for 11 and give a resource to... I can't do it on Berevor. I guess he'll do it on himself. And I'm done. So we have 11?
Sounds about right. Did you commit 10? Because I commit 1.
10, yeah.
All right, doomed 1. Then I will pay a resource from Dune here to a test of will. Cut off, each player must discard an ally from card from all ally cards from his hand. Problem is, when you get a cut off as a treachery and then you get a cut off with a shadow, you're kind of boned.
Okay.
Anyway, so I'll cancel it.
I think that's the nastiest one.
So. Yeah, that one's pretty bad.
Well, that is an easy staging area. So we do easily 7. Next quest card. We cannot play or put into play more than one card from Zen each round. So that takes...
I can't remember if that's retroactive or not.
Yeah.
Like if we've played something before we get here.
Yeah, I would assume not. I would think that starting now, we can only play or put into play one.
All right, fair enough. We'll err on the side of difficulty. All right. Well, that's simple enough.
I don't have really nothing to do.
Okay. Give me a shadow for this Naga Scout. I want to smash it.
Do you want to defend?
I do. If he gets plus three attack, I will scream. Okay, no shadow effect. Oops. All right. I'm sorry, did we can't travel to the West Bank locations yet,
Yeah.
right? All right, then I will attack with Dune here for a total of three attacks since he's not going into the staging area, which is enough to kill him. And for the hell of it, I'll ready Dune here with the Warhorse, just because I can.
Oh, and Erlewin's gonna contribute.
Oh, sure. Why not?
Nothing better to do.
And yeah,
Refresh.
Dave, so 2B, we still cannot travel to the West Bank. So now we are on the East Bank. Next, we will be in the river. Sorry.
And
Oh, that. That's just depressing. Right. Go ahead and plan.
I'll spend a resource from Teodred for one of these guys, two from Teodred for one of these guys, and wait, I'm totally cheating again. We can only play our opponent to play one per turn, so
This is true.
I'll just put that guy, I guess. So does that mean I couldn't sneak attack Gandalf because I would play sneak attack and put in play Gandalf?
Yeah, I would interpret that as correct. You would play sneak attack, but then this would cancel its effect because you're playing sneak attack.
And then put into play. Okay, well, I cheated for pretty much every other game I played in this quest. Oh, jeez. Okay, I'm done.
Right, go ahead and quest.
Oh, you don't buy anything?
No, next turn I'll be able to play something, but this turn I need to keep that spirit resource around.
I'll use the healer to heal your two guys.
Why, thank you, Saw.
And I'll send one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. How much do we need? Nine,
No, we need
ten,
to make 5
eleven,
progress.
twelve, 13. I'll send 13.
All right.
First
I feel
card.
like you got it, so I'm gonna
Okay.
hold back.
This guy is gonna get plus three threats, so I'll do this. Oh, that's not good.
Oh, I got him. Don't you worry.
I think we'll be just out of range to pass this stage. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. However, oh yeah, I can't put
God,
in.
this is such good Asphaloth food. I'm so sad.
Yeah. I'll use Berevor to draw two cards. Not that it's gonna matter
Selfish
much.
bastard.
Yep. And we might as well travel to the runes.
Yes, sir. So what, we went 3 progress? Okay. All right, so we go to the ruins.
This guy's gonna engage you at the start of the encounter phase.
Shoot, I was just formulating plans on how you could take him and defend with the Urn Rider and kill him with Theodred. All right.
Yeah.
It's all right, we're good. We got it. And the Wainrider captain can stay the hell up there. Right, give me a shadow. Éomer will defend.
Drum rolls, nothing.
Perfect. All right, so one attack, two defense, no damage. Dune here will attack at him for three attack.
Okay.
And ready up with the Rohan Warhorse. And then I will play Unseen Strike on Dune here to give him plus three attack. And declare him as an attacker against the Wainrider Captain. So he's rocking a total of eight attack. More than enough to kill that Wainrider Captain.
Nicely done.
Dune here is riding down the Wainriders like a boss.
Do you need a resource?
Sure.
Okay. All
right.
And let's refresh.
Yeah, I'm kind of basking in the nerdy thematic element of Dune here, the Outrider of Rohan, just plowing down the Wainriders before they can do anything. I can tell that you share my nerd slaver.
Well, Irluin was there too, and the Fields of Pelennor, so yeah. There's only Berevor, who's totally out of place. Firstly, because she doesn't exist, and well, not in the Tolkien world anyways.
All right. I don't suppose you could spare any card draw this turn.
Yeah. You can draw two.
Fantastic. All right. Now we can play some things.
You need a resource.
Sure. I don't know who I want to put it on, so let me reserve judgment here. I want to save. You know what? You're doing things over there. I'm going to pay one, and so I'll just pretend that's the one you gave me. And I'll put a Dagger Western S on Hirluin, since he's actually...
Yeah, and you can only put in play one card per turn, so...
Give it back.
Yeah.
All right. That being said... Ah, then I got to hold on to it, because I want to be able to cancel Treachery. I want to have that option.
Yeah. Yeah. Fair enough. I'll spend two for one of these guys and go on to questing.
All right. And a quest it shall be.
So I'll send two. I assume you don't send anybody.
That's presumptuous of you. Correct, but presumptuous.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That should be enough. And I'll use the healer to heal your two heroes.
Woohoo! All right. Slowly getting a handle.
And a one and a two.
You know what I'm noticing as an older quest? I'm noticing the distinct lack of surge, and it's kind of wonderful. Two players, two cards.
Yeah. I gotta say, I know there's at least one treachery, but I don't think we've seen it. Yeah, there's one in this discard pile. Mm. But yeah, it's pretty light. Okay, so one, two, three. Okay, we've got enough. I won't bother counting.
All right, so we get through the ruins and...
Progress tokens from card effects cannot be placed on this quest card or active location. Players cannot travel to either East Bank or West Bank locations, and we've got either discard a hero or one ranger of Attilion. How appropriate. Somebody's going to die.
Is the ranger of Attilion? Oh, they have the Gondor trait. That's interesting. You could have played the Sword of Morthond on it.
Yeah, I thought about it, but I... He was my meat shield for that quest stage, so.
Hey, Mr. Trent showed up. How's it going, dude? Well, we've lost a hero, but we're winning the war. That's how it's going. All right, so.
I won't optionally engage anybody.
So we can't travel to West Bank or East Bank, so no travel. I suppose I'll engage the wolves from Mordor. Shoot, but if I chump, he's just going to fly back into the deck. Oh, well, nothing I can do about it.
I can take him. actually.
Can you kill him?
Yeah.
Because I have no ranged.
That's fine.
Okay.
Because the thing from the second quest stage isn't in play anymore, so.
Okay, cool. Go for it.
Shadow card. I'll spend one resource from Theodred for a sneak attack Gandalf. I will lower my threat.
Good call.
To make sure that if we die threaded out, I'll be the last one standing.
So you think.
And one, two. So I've got enough attacks with my allies and heroes, so I'll defend with Gandalf. So there's the search card.
Oh, there's the one you're talking about. No shadow effect, though, which is lovely.
Yep. And I'll counterattack with this slot. And all kill right. The damn thing. So this guy pops back into my hand. Sneak attack is discarded.
Oh, yeah, and Aomer goes into beast mode.
And nothing. It's so funny. All my guys are exhausted, and yours are like chilling.
I expected to have something to do.
Yeah. Well, me too, but. Oh, well. Okay, let's refresh.
And, Dave, local joke, what area of the country and/or world would that be? All right, now we got some play. Anyway, you plan. If you can spare any resources, I could use.
Go ahead.
Woo-hoo.
I'll send one your way. And I'll spend two from Theodred for another one of these ones. So do you want to, this is overkill maybe at this point. Do you want a resource on one of your Aomer maybe?
I could use it if you don't need it.
Yeah. I don't need it. And I'll spend three from Hirluin for this guy, the fatty.
Ooh, do you meet the condition yet? Oh, you're short of tactics.
Yeah.
Right, aren't you? All right.
I'll spend two for another healer. And
you know what? Let me just go ahead and make this easier on you.
Okay.
I'll move my little private party over here.
This. And that's going to be it.
All right.
Do you need cards?
No, I actually think I should be okay. I mean, okay. If you've like got card draw to spare.
No,
but
I'll draw for myself.
I'm good for this turn.
And I'll spend one for one of these. And I'll use this for transfer. And I'll spend two for one of these.
Jeez.
And I'll look at this guy, draw it. And oh, shit, I don't have the resources. Oh, well. Yeah, it's ridiculous, Outlands. I forgot it. How good they were. Okay.
Oh, yeah, and Mr. Trench, we're actually trying something interesting tonight. Well, I don't know if this is interesting. I'm keeping the chat window open over here intentionally for the YouTubers. Because I have to imagine watching these on YouTube is kind of like hearing one half of a phone conversation. That's somewhat annoying. So we're going to try it out. Anyway, so I'll pay two for an Aether Swordsman. I'll pay two for a Westfold Horsebreaker, which apparently is a good word for Brian's love life, as it turns out, if his post is to be believed. Now I'll pay one for Dagger of Westerness over on Hirluin.
Thank you.
Dave asks if I'm in Ohio. Oh, I don't have to actually read it from the chat anymore. I just went over that. No, I'm not in Ohio. I actually live in Minnesota. I'm a couple of hours away from Brian. If you know where Brian lives. He lives in the Twin Cities. I'm a little farther north of there. Then we're going to pay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for a Gandalf. And I'll lower my threat by 5.
Oh, so that's how it's going to work, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, it's the Gandalf arms race. All right, that's it for me.
Okay, I'll sacrifice this guy.
Yep, so per the quest, in order to commit any characters to the quest, that player has to either first choose a hero or a ranger of Athelion and discard it.
I'll send 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 19, 19.
All right, now you're just showing off.
Yeah, maybe. 20? And that should be enough.
Hey, Okwazo. Glad you made it.
First card. One of these guys. Second card. One of these guys. Third card. Okay.
Yeah, and Mr. Trench recounting how I lost my Glorfindel. Dave, I appreciate it. Brave is a word. Maybe not the one I'd use.
Stab in the back by a goblin.
It was the happenstance of a very unfortunate shadow card. I took a Snaga Scout and I thought I was safe. Anyway.
Oh, you're never safe. You're never safe in Middle Earth.
How did we get three cards up there?
Because isn't the captain bringing somebody back? Yep.
Oh, yep, you're right. Sorry.
Okay, so we are crossing the Anduin. And last quest stage adds the Witch King to the staging area. I gain another one of these guys. So he shouldn't be up there.
All right. The Witch King cometh.
What else?
So does anyone else think that the 666 was just a play on the number of the beast? Or do you think they legitimately separately thought, okay, well, he should have 6 threat. He should have 6 attack. I should probably have 6 defense.
It is coincidental, isn't it? Go to the Pelnor Fields.
Or raise our threat by 3. Is that worth it? I suppose we're doing all right for locations.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, there's only like 30 threat in the staging area. I can't handle it.
All right, so do any of these guys have to come down? Oh, yeah, you're still at 29, you slacker. So the wolves are both going to have to come. I should be able to take the Wainrider captain easily enough.
Okay. I will. Oh, I don't have a ton of attack. Each character gets -1 willpower. Don't you have enough attack to kill the Witch King?
Do I? I might.
I don't know. Here the wind sends 3 your way.
All right, so let's take a look.
Yeah, if you sacrifice
Oh, Quazo, I'm sorry. I tried to update the name of the stream, but by the time I realized that apparently the edit didn't stick, it was too late. So this is massing at Osgiliath. Anyway. So if you commit 3 attack, and I chump block with my horse breeder, I can muster 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 attack.
+3 is 18, and he has 17.
All right. Well, let's leave the Wainrider captain up there then.
Yeah, let's do it. Okay. And I'll let the wolves go down to me.
Yeah, and, Okwazo, I think we plan to continue the first age quests. I know Brandon really wants to be there, so we decided not to do it since he couldn't make it tonight. As well, I think we were going to try to hold out for when Ian could come and play Dungeon Master for us, because that would be pretty rocking. But we'll see, because he's got a lot of stuff going on in his personal life at present, so.
Okay, so I'm the first player.
Oh, so you took both of them?
Well, they come down to me whether I want it or not.
Right? Oh, sure. All right.
This guy has 3 defense, so we should be fine.
Ha! So you thought.
4, 5, 6, 7. You know, being an outland is a tough, tough place to be. They're not, especially those guys, they don't boost anybody, so
yeah,
you might as well die.
All right, so he dies and the wolves go away.
Right.
For long.
For long or not for long, as Brandon would say. He will take 1 damage.
I think Brandon's exact joke when I played with him and he used the Outlands deck was, yeah, oh, he's not for long for this world.
Oh.
Or for right. long this, I don't know. You fill in the blank. You guys know what Brandon's like.
I'll heal those 2 with the Warden and you can go ahead.
All right. I will defend the Witch. Oh, God, this just seems cruel, but I'm going to throw the Westfold Horse Breeder at the Witch King. Oh, no! No!
So we won't be able to kill him, right?
No!
I don't care about your hero. I'm just concerned that I won't be able to kill him.
God dang it. All right. Well, I don't think there's any way I can weasel out of this if it's considered undefended. I have no shadow cancel. You don't have any card draw that you can throw me at the last second, do you?
Nope.
Because I know I have hasty strokes in here. All right. Well, that's fun. So, what do we think? Do we want to be able to continue to attack stuff in the staging area, or...
Yeah,
I guess the real question is, what do I want to be able to continue to pay for?
Yeah, that's more the situation, because Dunhear like is a pretty good attacker right in front of you too, because he can attack twice, but I don't think you'll be engaged with 2 guys at once that often.
Yeah,
but
if I'm not attacking to the staging area, Aomir is going to be much bigger. All right, yeah, as much as Dunhear is my favorite child, I'm going to go have to Sophie's Choice him to death here. Oh, man. Rohan is riding to ruin.
The good news is the Westfold Horse Breeder is still alive.
Small miracles, my friend.
You've got to appreciate the little stuff.
All right, well, that's interesting. Okay. So let's do the math again here.
Yeah.
So
I'll just put a few ones on my guy here and we'll move on. So that's 1, 2, 3. So he's just barely alive.
Yep. All right. So if you help me for 3, I go in with Gandalf. That makes us 7. If I go in with Aomer, that makes us 14 because he's 5 by himself with his buff and then another 2 for the dagger.
Yeah.
So did I say 14?
Yeah, we're at 14.
And then another 4 is 18. So I think we still pulled it off.
Oh, by miscounting? That's
yeah,
funny.
Because I forgot about my dagger.
Ah.
All
okay,
right.
Well, I'm fine with that.
So Aomer bitch slaps the Witch King. Oh, wait, hang on. After he attacks, he returns to the staging area unless I raise my threat by 3, which I will do. All right.
Okay, so he's dead. And hopefully he won't get reshuffled into the deck. And,
it's so silly that there's no victory points on the Witch King.
Yeah.
Seen him come back.
They could have put victory 0, and everybody would have been thinking, like, well, what's that about? But that's exactly what it's about.
It's
you don't
the
want
effing Witch King. He should have victory
yeah.
20. Anyway,
isn't that one of the either the Karak or the Overhill and Underhill quests where the trolls come back? It's so annoying.
Yeah,
the name trolls.
I think Karak. The trolls do not have victory points, so they can come back.
That's annoying.
I want to say we must away. They all have victory points.
Okay. In any case,
all
from
right.
my perspective, that went well.
Well, At least I'm still contributing something. I killed the damn Witch King. That's a feather in my cap. All right, Gandalf goes away. Let's start a new turn. You don't have anything that gives me a spirit resource icon, do you?
Maybe I put one Calibrian stone in there somewhere. I'll draw and look for it. Whenever I play leadership, I always put one.
Iquazo, no women participated in the attack, but thematic win still because a woman fainted and participated in the defense, even though she didn't die. So there you go. It's even a Rohan woman. Squee away. I'm sorry, I'm not playing anything. Did I already say that?
Oh, I don't think so. But okay, I'll go ahead with two resources for this guy. One, two resources for this guy, which makes me look at discard, which gets discarded. And that will be it.
All right.
So let's quest mad. I'll play a sneak attack Gandalf.
I'll throw two in. No, I'm sorry. That's three. Because the Aether Swordsman gives him a plus one. Gives himself a plus one.
Okay. I'll lower my threat with Gandalf because we care about score.
No, you just want to outdo me.
Yep.
Because
yep.
You know I'm never going to be able to afford another Gandalf now.
Shh. Don't tell anybody.
You
four,
heal.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 20, 23, 26, 29, 30, 33, 35,
oh, 7, 38, 41. Oh my god. He just flattens his side of the table and throws in 41. 44?
That would have been simpler, right? First, second. Oh, there's the surge.
Hey, I can't cancel it now.
I'll discard another Forlong and Faramir.
No, that's not surge. Oh. It's just doomed.
Oh, whoops. My bad. Looks like. So, doomed one. Whoops. Doomed one. There you go. And that is it.
All right, so how'd we fare? I'm pretty sure we win, right?
Yep. Score of 140, average.
You know how I feel about the score. So that's a baseline now if we ever, with two players, take on massing again. For that's anything right. else, it means nothing.
It will go on for the generations to come. People
right
will
on.
We scored 140.
Yes. Well, guys, we're playing it high and tight tonight. You know, normally, let's see here. Our werewolf quest, since we played it with three people, ended up quiet, Dave. You know what? You guys, everyone contributed. I killed the Witch King. I was there. And Etienne just silently takes the praise.
Yep.
Oh, no, Tom just joined.
Oh, no.
Tom, as I was just saying, normally this is a 2.5 hour affair.
Not today because I was
tonight,
there.
Tonight you're running with Sean and Etienne. We play it high and tight. Fast and loose. Heroes flying off the table.
The truth is Outlands was on the table. So
quiet, you. We're going to take credit. Superkiller got Twitch working again. Fantastic. Hopefully, I think we're doing this again Tuesday next week. So join us then. This has been a fun, quick... You know, I just feel like this one never had time to get tedious, which is really nice. The last couple of quests that we've done, particularly with campaign... And I'm not sure if it's to blame. You know, it's definitely part that we add more players, so there's way more to each staging step, each quest, you know, each combat step. But then part of it, you know, massing is just fast and furious anyway, so.
But I found that the most recent quests really get a little fiddlier than the earlier quests. And Massing is a good example. It's very straightforward.
Yes, I would agree. Particularly the Black Riders, I find staging takes for freaking ever because you're doing high tests, you're fetching stuff from the encounter deck and reshuffling. You're getting attacks mid. I mean, it's all fun and it's all thematic, but at the same time, when you're playing four players, it can get tedious, as we've seen. So, Etienne, since we finished so quickly, I don't know. It looks like there's a request for something else. Are you down? I still have.
Sure.
I budgeted for at least 2 hours tonight, so.
Yeah, let's.
All right.
Let's another one.
Let's take another request. What does everyone want to see played? We'll let the 15-second delay.
Yeah, I'll try and catch up on what people. Oh, people have been praising me. Wonderful.
Oh, you didn't have the chat up?
Yeah, it was on the right screen, but I forgot to look at it for a long time.
Oh, well, they were calling you an asshole for like the whole rest of the first part of the quest, and then once you actually started to pull your weight, then they're Fairweather fans, so. Do we actually want to coordinate the decks that we're going to play this time? You know, surprisingly, this basically amounted to a pickup game as far as deck coordination goes, and it worked pretty well. You know, Dune here pulled his weight in mitigating the enemies we actually had to fight, and that allowed you to quest more rapidly. Mr. Trench, no.
How about Nightmare? No. Nightmare main wheel. Are you
Maybe. I don't know if I have the image pack updated for that. Let's check. I'm willing to do it. I haven't played Nightmare Emin Will more than halfway through yet, so.
I'll double check if I know I played it, but I don't remember if it's on this computer on my laptop, so I'll just double check. I've got the files as well.
Alright, so we'll check on Emin Will, but we'll keep taking suggestions if there's an overwhelming the one with the terror chasing you in Dwaradelph is Flight from Moria. That's the one with the Nameless Fear, which I'm very excited. I haven't had a chance to go out and buy the Moria Nightmare decks yet, but those one I'm actually quite excited for.
Mr. Trent's like, oh my god, they're actually doing it.
Well, Mr. Trench, you have to understand that with the past couple playthroughs, I legitimately blocked off, 2 to 3 hours tonight to do this, expecting it would take that long. So if we only go 2 hours, I'm cool with it.
Yeah. And there's also Escape from Moria, Long Dark, Amundin suggested.
I challenge Morgul Brandon to Vale. Use the new attack deck.
I think Stu did Morgul Vale near the when we started putting stuff on YouTube. So
yeah, that was the first.
I'd skip that one for tonight. Let's do something new.
Yeah, kill the Nameless Fear. All right, so it looks like the contenders are currently Flight from Moria, and let's just narrow it down. Flight from Moria and Nightmare Emin Muil. Place your votes, and we'll get it going here.
What's the new kill in this staging area stuff? Isn't that what you were playing?
I think that's what he's referring to. I know there's Firefoot coming out, but I don't think he's targeting stuff in the staging area. Let's see. All right. You know what? Here, let's reset. And do you want to load up Nightmare Emin Muil just to make sure it's an option, if that's the way we end up going? I don't know if I have the image pack installed.
Okay, I'll just load it and we'll see what you see.
And it looks like that's the way the vote's going anyway, so. Yeah, I don't think I have the image pack here.
Okay, well, we'll do something else. Do you have the one from maybe Journey Along the End, the core set? Oh, well, actually, let's go with what they were. Oh, yeah, they all want Nightmare Mini.
Nope, hang on. Tom's stopping me. He might be coming to the rescue here.
Never mind.
Okay. It's all right. Well, we'll probably plan that for the next time. It's just you and me, since we seem to be the only ones who enjoy the nightmare decks.
Okay, so let's... what was the second one? The
Were we thinking
escape?
Flight from Moria, I think.
Okay. So, quest... Flight from Moria... The picture I have of that quest is Boromir with a steam drill just readying himself to dig his way like a madman through the side of the mountain.
Wait, what? The
like, with have? The tactic Boromir, mm-hmm. you can just use his ability to raise your threat by 3 and just use the... Like, the whole point of the prospector tools mm-hmm. to get out of Moria was to... You can
oh,
only...
Oh, right. Yeah.
You have to exhaust and stuff. Boromir can just bypass that. Super cheap.
Boromir is the win button to a few kind of janky quests. He does that for Assault on Osgiliath too, if you start with the right location in play.
I suggest we take a dwarf deck. I could take my Thorin deck.
Oh yeah, do you want to do our Storm of Dwarves combo?
I think it'd be appropriate.
Works for me.
I don't want to take the wrong one. Quest specific.
Oh yeah, and Trench is asking if it's not true. Oh, look what you did. Oh,
damn it.
I don't know, Trench, we'll find out. I think you might be right if you do exhaust. I think you might have to exhaust the tools to use them. So we'll have to see. We'll probably find them in this playthrough. We'll hopefully find them in this playthrough. Because to my mind, that's the most consistent way to get out of Moria, right?
Yeah.
All right. Ooh, been a while since I've played this deck. Let me make sure I know what I want. The Nameless Fear.
Per player, one back, so we'll put 2. And shuffle. We'll just put those.
All right, so set up. We're adding the Nameless Fear. We're removing all copies of Foe from Beyond. And then shuffling an equal amount of Foe from Beyond into the deck to the amount of players in the game. Foe from Beyond makes the... No, he doesn't even make him attack. We just basically deal damage equal to the Nameless Fear's attack to a hero. And it can't be canceled, which is always fun.
Do I want to keep this? I don't think so.
Yeah, I got a Molly Mine, so we're going to go ahead and do that. Ew. All right, I can work with it.
Okay, we've got to reveal 2 cards. You ready?
Ready.
Let's go.
Hey, that's a good setup one.
In the good old days where they didn't surge when they whiffed. I miss those days. Oh. Each player may choose and discard 1 card random from his hand or it surges.
I really don't want to do that. I've got 2 cards in my hand that are really good. Yeah, we might as well. I don't want it to surge. We can dig out earlier if we don't have a terrible staging area.
Okay.
All right, so we'll do a random discard. All right, well, that could have been worse.
All right, so we've got a... Wait, then add presence in the dark. So I'll just put some resources right here.
Sounds good.
I'll add the questage.
So that goes to our victory display, which gives us victory 2. And the Nameless Fear is a bunch of X's. The X's being the number of victory points in the victory display.
And now we have I don't think I shuffled them. I think I should shuffle them. So shuffle and control Q. And we don't flip it yet.
Right. Yep, flip it at the beginning of staging. All right, let's control end it up.
Let's roll. So, okay, what did you lose? Was it important?
No, I just lost what could have been a little bit of card draw.
Okay. So I'll spend two resources to bring this guy. Do I want to trigger it? I can't remember if I put some hidden caches in this deck. I'll totally cheat, look, and reshuffle. It's been a while. I did not, so I will not trigger it. And I'm done.
All right. I will use Biffer's ability and pay a resource from Owen and add it to Biffer. Pay two to put a Miner of the Iron Hills into play. And that's all I got this turn.
Okay. I'll spend one resource to sneak attack Gandalf and draw myself three cards. Perfect. And I'll send... it's tough when we don't know what's coming up. I'll send two. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13. And maybe you can go easier on questing and I don't know. You don't have a lot of really good attackers, so maybe.
Yeah, I mean, it's really moot anyway, so I'll just go for six. Well, yeah. What's six, assuming Dane stays ready?
Yeah.
And Trenchhead, I have to think Brian also loves his easy mode, although he doesn't say it as much as Brandon does.
I'll cheat again and keep Gandalf.
What's a retcon amongst friends?
Like the deck isn't gonna defend itself, so might as well take advantage of it.
Well, wait, hang on. Did you sneak attack Gandalf into play?
Yeah.
So he's gonna pop back after questing is done.
Oh yeah, that's stupid. Yeah,
they might as well. All right, so now we reveal this at the beginning of staging. When revealed, reveal one encounter card per player. Ooh, that's fun. So now
that's gonna be.
All right, here we go. Yeah. First player attaches Shadow of Fear to one of his heroes. I want one per hero attached to... Oh, sure, and I just played my Miner of the Iron Hills. F you, game. F you.
Cannot exhaust already.
Maybe Thorin, since he's going to accumulate resources most quickly. Up to you, though.
Yeah.
You're going to have to pay three to get rid of it, so. That sucks.
Cannot exhaust already, so. Because I'll be able to get rid of this next turn. That's the thing. So, yeah, I'll put it on him. He's the less valuable one right now. Okay, second card. Each player may choose and discard. I don't mind discarding.
See, what I don't like about the wording of this card is each player may choose at random. That fights itself. I'm just bitter. I will do it.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Yes.
So it's like, oh, you get the choice, but you've got to choose at random. So deceitful. Okay, random discard. What did I throw down? Allure of Moria. I'm not going to pay for that anytime soon, so I don't care. So that was just the when revealed effect, so when you still need to...
Yes, now we're doing actual staging.
Okay, wonderful.
All right.
That's two. And what does this do? Enemies get plus one attack. That's not too bad. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
How much did you send?
19. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, wait, what? We're 19 in the staging area?
No, 13 in the staging area.
And we sent 19?
Yeah.
Oh, that's respectable. All right, fair enough. I completely forgot you had Gandalf down.
Yeah. So this goes to the victory display. It pumps up this guy.
That's right, guys. Dwarf Dex. 19 willpower on the first turn.
First turn. When we had two cards revealed before the game began and four cards revealed in staging with the Balrog in the staging area. Pretty beast. Okay, let's travel to, I guess, the armory. I don't really see why we wouldn't. It's three threat anyways. We get a benefit from it. Agreed?
Yeah.
Yep, they're both three threats, so
works for me. And okay. This one we get through faster anyway, so yep, good call.
So we could leave that goblin there, or we can just keep him busy.
Well, at this point, we might as well get him out of there. It is almost like Dane is overpowered.
So
how much? Just so he'd have to muster four attack. Yeah.
I mean, I can keep take him as well. Doesn't really matter. It's all a question of who's going to bring some fighting power faster, and that's maybe going to be me. I don't know.
Mine is not imminent. Unless I draw into something that changes it.
Okay, I'll take him.
Yep.
So Shadow Card, he's going to defend. Come on, Bomber.
Well, that's a net neutral effect.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Let's refresh. Ori is still exhausted. And he will not draw me an extra card. Torin gets an extra resource.
Yes, sir. I got one sec. All right.
The guy in the chat room said it's a nameless spirit and you can't name it. Well, I just did.
You're going to draw a phobia on this turn. Watch it happen. Yep, it's going to be the last player, too. Just watch it. Okay. I will do nothing. Yeah, I wouldn't be able to play anything even if I do that. So, yep, nothing for me.
Okay, I'll play this guy, I guess. And which one is more valuable? Spend one resource for a Dunedain warning on Bomber.
Good call.
And that will be it. So let's quest.
I'll throw in my six.
I'll send.
God, what are we up against?
Yeah, now it's getting tricky. I'm sending six as well. I could send another one, but that would maybe leave me with an undefended attack if another enemy comes up.
Nah, you're okay.
Okay.
All right, so staging.
13.
It reveals itself at the beginning of the staging. Let's see where we go. Hey! When revealed, each player chooses one questing character he controls. Each character not chosen does not count. It's, oh god, that's terrible.
That's going to be bad.
But we get the abandoned tools out of it, is why I said hey. So I guess I'll choose Biffer.
So we're sending seven.
Ooh.
That is not good.
This is going to be rough.
First. Oh, there. So it does.
Yeah.
Okay, 1.2.
Oh. The threat.
Okay.
The threat.
Doom one.
Oh, well, yeah, because that.
Because we're not hurting enough already. And reveal another two encounter cards.
Oh, God. All right. Well, here we go.
Two. And two. Three, four.
Oh, no.
One,
oh,
two.
No. Each of the enemies in the staging area is plus
one.
Two.
Why plus? Oh.
Because of the drummer, two is the number of players in the game. So we're about to go up a lot of threat right now.
And even the Nameless Sphere is an enemy.
Yes.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 24.
24 to our 7.
So that's 17. So I'm at 47.
That's pretty much the worst combo this thing could have hit us with. Good lord. That's fun. All right.
Do you want to engage?
Well, this is all academic at this point, I feel, but all right, so yeah, and we don't even get the abandoned tools till after we place progress on narrow pads. Fantastic. I suppose I'll take a spearman.
I'll take the drummer just to get him out of there.
Okay. I'll take the other spearman.
Okay.
All right. I guess Dane will defend. Oh, God, I'm losing a hero. All right, I guess Dane will defend one. Well, the one on the left. All right, well, that's good because that would have taken me out of the game.
Mm-hmm.
So two attack, three defense, no damage. And the other one's going undefended, which means he gets four attack plus whatever his shadow gives him. Which is nothing. So I'm going to assign the undefended damage to Owen.
Why didn't you defend with the miner?
Oh, I have a miner I can defend with.
Yeah.
Because I'm just in, like, hero killing mode tonight. That's why.
Yeah.
All right.
So he takes a wound.
All right. So, yeah, that actually went much better than losing a hero.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Okay. Bomber's going to defend the stray goblin. I chose the right enemy to defend against. And then the drummer is going to be undefended. I can't do anything about that one. And I'll put the damage on Ori.
All right.
Still alive.
For a little bit. Here we go. God dang it.
Okay, so Torin gets a resource. I get an extra card.
All right, I can swarm a little bit this turn. We'll see if we do better.
Let me think. Do you have an attachment in your discard pile you want back?
Yeah, I could use it back. I won't be able to play it this turn, but at some point.
So
if you've got something more immediately useful, go ahead and take it for yourself.
Yeah.
It's card draw.
Yeah,
I have alternate means of card draw, so I'm good.
Yeah. Okay, I'll start off with this. Shuffle, look at top five. Ooh. This guy is tempting. Sort of.
If you could get two of them, that would be great. If you keep your record keeper, though, you can ready bomber for more defense.
Well, I'll probably spend the resources, but maybe I should.
I don't know. Tough call, man. All you.
Three. I think I need more bodies on the table, so I'll put those two.
Okay.
And do you want to get the attachment?
Oh, sure.
I have nothing useful. So that was free, although time consuming. I'll spend two for, I'll put that on Dane, Hardy Leadership. Maybe it's going to keep us alive one more turn than it normally would.
All right, fair enough.
And I'll take out another of these guys and go ahead.
All right. Biffer's going to steal one from Owen. He'll pay one for a Legacy of Durin. I don't know. What do you think? Probably diversify. Thorin's probably going to stick around, right? No, never mind. I need it right now.
Yeah.
All right. So then I will pay three from Dane to play Glowing. And when I now control five dwarf characters, as I do when I play Glowing, I get to add two resources to a dwarf heroes pool. Or is it just a heroes pool? It's a heroes pool. I'll put it back on Dane. Then I will play A Very Good Tale, exhausting these two. Shuffle and discard. Cash went away. All right. So we're going to grab the Hammersmith and the Erdnimerous Prospector. Then when he enters play, I get to discard the top three cards of my deck, choose one, and shuffle back.
Didn't you get two resources from the cash?
Sure did. Thank you. I saw it come off and then I kind of blew past it. Maybe. I think my better choice is here. Okay, so there's discarding the top three. Now I get to shuffle one of my discards back into my deck. I'm going to shuffle a cash back in. Hopefully hit it again. Because my next play is going to be another Very Good Tale.
Nice.
One, two, aha! Three, four. So now I'll add the cash resources there, and you know, just so we see what the cash does. Whenever it's discarded off your deck, you add two resources to the resource pool of a hero you control. So that's why that's awesome. And I suppose I'll grab Dory and a record keeper. Swarming. Oh, now that I have resources, I will pay two to put King Under the Mountain on Dane, and then I'll exhaust King Under the Mountain to look at the top two cards of my deck, adding one to my hand, discarding the other. Also works with hidden cash, I might point out. So I'll discard that and add that to my hand. I'll pay one resource to actually play Hidden Cash, drawing a card. Sorry, guys, this is like my longest turn ever. But I'm doing a lot. Then I'll pay two for another Erebor Hammersmith. I don't think I have anything in here worth taking back. Oh, yeah, I do. I'll take back that. And then I'll pay two to play Steward of Gondor on Biffer. Nope. Maybe. I don't know. I'm indecisive. We'll put it on Dane. And exhaust it to add two. And that's how you play a turn.
Discard.
Oh, don't get bitter.
No, that's good.
All right. That's it for me.
That's really good. Okay. Let's quest. I'll spend one for a sneak attack Gandalf. Classic move. And I'll lower my threat.
Are you sure you don't want to put four wounds on the Nameless Sphere?
No. It's a trap. Okay. And I'll... Let's see. We're going to have to quest pretty hard. 4, 5, 6 for sure.
Oh, good point. I think Tom caught me in an error. Does the Airborne Hammersmith is the topmost attachment? Yep, and I had just discarded my King of the Mountain, so my Sword of Gondor is still in my discard pile. And instead, my King of the Mountain's in my hand.
And that's why we have our listeners.
Aha. All right.
Okay, I'm sending 6. I don't think we're really in a rush. It'd be nice to clear the active location.
Well, I'm at 46 threats. Yeah. So that's somewhat pressing.
Well, yeah. Yeah, let's...
Crap, I wish I were playing my Nori variant. I'd be back down to, like, 35 right now.
13. Is 13 enough? How much are you expecting to send?
I can send 6, 7, 8... I have to exhaust Ori or Dory to use his attack. I could send, because I want to keep my Erebor Record Keeper up to ready Owen, so I can actually kill something this turn.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I could send 8. The next turn I'll be able to send a ton more.
Okay, I'll send 13.
All right. I'll send my 8.
That's 21.
Oh, also, hang on. I think I missed. How many did I actually play that turn? Did I just play the 2? My card draw from Legacy of Durin? There was some shuffling in there, so these probably weren't the cards I would have actually drawn, but, you know. I operate under Schrodinger's law of card draw.
I think I'll send one more of these guys. I'm feeling it might not be enough. Okay, first card.
Hey, guarded.
Well, that whole quest stage was pointless then. The whole point was to find those stupid tools. Oh, jeez. Okay.
Oh, thank God we actually have allies committed. So first player is you.
He controls. Oh, shoot. I can't choose one of yours. I could choose Gandalf. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're going against 14 right now. We've got 23, so I think I'll choose Gandalf.
Wait, hang on. Did none of your allies commit? Or are you just between heroes and Gandalf?
Oh, I could choose just the record keeper if I wanted, but I think we have enough questing power. And... if
right,
Gandalf...
Gandalf would go back to your hand, which gives you the opportunity to play him later.
Yeah.
Your call, but I would ditch the record keeper.
Okay. And second one.
Yeah, not what we
plus
need.
Plus 3 attack. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 plus 6 is 12 plus 4 is 16 against 23. So that clears this and that.
All right, search so for... we already have the abandoned tools, so that's not an issue.
So we add this to the victory display, add one more threat, put the next quest stage. After it leaves play as an explore location, each player may attach a weapon or armor attachment. I don't have any.
I want to give Narvi's belt the armor trait.
And let's go to the Faldwell.
That'll work.
Exhaust a hero to claim the abandoned tools. I'm a little too busy right now for that.
Yeah, we're kind of locked down at the moment. God, and we've got two more enemies coming down. It's gonna be rough.
I can take the chieftain. If you take the spearman.
That'll work. If you're sure you can take him.
Well, then I'll chum block.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Do I want to start with the easiest or the worst?
Oh, shoot.
Trying to think of the treacheries in this quest.
All right, well, I'm going to spend a lore resource and exhaust my record keeper to ready Owen.
Okay. I'll exhaust the record, the Hammersmith against the Chieftain of the Pit. Dylan. Yeah.
Shit. That's.
He has 4 hit points, but. Yeah, he's gone.
God, we are getting boned with the undefended attacks.
The
tonight.
Good news is Torin survives. Ooh, yeah, because of hardy leadership. No, he doesn't. That's 8 attacks. Never mind.
Yeah, so I would not do Thorin.
Okay.
All right.
This guy, then? I am scared. Deal 1 damage to the defending character. Of course you will. Little bastard. And then this guy. Okay. Nothing.
Right. Fair enough. God, I was really hoping to be able to attack back this turn. That's so lame. Alright, anyway. We'll go the leftmost guy against Dane. Come on! Next guy against Owen. No! 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 God. Fine. Take our heroes. Take them all. Dory.
Well, you could. Oh, no. You didn't want to. Yeah. Because I guess you could have exhausted Dory, but.
Either way, I'm taking 4 undefended, so.
Yeah. But you gotta put it on Dane.
I suppose. But we've got no healing. Yeah. So I had to deal 4. Because of the shadow effect, I had to deal 4 there. Right? Okay, so hang on. So Dane. Owen. Dory could have saved him, but then I'd be undefended here. Yeah, that's probably the best play because it's.
Aquazo is asking if I had a better attachment on top, but I didn't. So.
Oh boy, you were getting some lag. He asked that a while ago.
Well, it's in the middle of the chat box. I just wasn't
looking. Oh, gotcha.
Looking.
All right, so redo. Sorry, retcon. So Dane defended here.
You could even put it on Owen if you want it because he has 5 hit points right now. But
oh god, you're right. I keep forgetting. Okay, so yeah, that changes it by itself. So okay, fair enough. So now we're all +1 hit points because of hardy leadership. This guy Owen defends. Deal damage to the defending character equals to that. So then at that point I would exhaust Dory. Should I do it at that point? No, I'll just deal 4 damage. No, but then he would get 1. God! Friggin' A. Alright, I'll exhaust Dory to cancel any amount of damage assigned to a hero. So, 2 attack to 1 defense goes 1 wound. This guy's undefended. Oh, hey, no shadow, lucky. So then I'll put 4 on old Dane.
Okay.
All right. Fair enough. Indecision theater.
That is rough. Okay. Refresh.
Well, they're swarming just like they're designed to. We just couldn't get caught up after that first staging. Lord. Whoops, sorry. All right. I'm going to exhaust King Under the Mountain, put in my top two cards. I'll discard one, take the other into my hand. I will pay two for a Steward of Gondor on Biva. Exhausted, give him a couple resources. I'll pay another two for Narvi's Belt on Biva. I'll exhaust it to give him a tactics resource icon. And I'll pay three for an Erebor Battlemaster. And then I'll pay one from Owen to play Dwalin, since he has his cost reduced by two. And you know what? For the shell of it, I'll pay another two to play out Azigil Minor. Oh, also keeping in mind that I'm drawing cards this whole time.
Yep. I just realized I can totally cheat and see your hand on my right screen.
I think we'll forego the pretense of table talk for our purposes tonight.
Don't tell anyone.
All right. Well, if I had done that in the right order. Nah, never mind. I've already retconned too much. Go ahead.
Okay, I'll do Dairon's Runes. And discard a Burning Brand.
Actually, no, I only drew two cards. No, I drew three. Trust thyself.
I'll exhaust this guy to give this Torin a resource and draw a card. I'll spend three resources for one of these. Nope, that's not true. One and one for one Envoy of Pelagir, giving back a resource to Torin, and then three for this guy. And that will be it.
All right. Oops, sorry. So, we should probably try to make some progress, huh?
Maybe. I guess, yeah. Who knows what's going to come up? That location is going to be a trouble. Five quest points.
All right, so I'm going to send six, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
That's pretty good. I can't defend forever, but send this guy for sure. This one for sure. And I'll leave it at that, I think. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Start out with 12. Yeah, that might not be enough. I'll send Thorin as well.
Yep.
24 against 12. Let's do it. First one, Doom 1.
Well,
oh,
I'm gone this turn.
Reveal X additional card from the encounter deck where X is the number of players. So three more to go. One, two.
Wait, hang on, before we do
sorry.
That, we have to reveal our search for an exit here.
Oh, right. That is true.
Oh, hey, exactly what we wanted. You might get out of this yet, buddy.
But it... What's the catch on that one? Yeah, it's for progress. Okay, so the first player that's going to be you attaches that to one of your heroes. Yeah. And that was the second, so we need a third one. If the players are on stage one, we are not. Shuffle the current quest card into the quest deck. Then reveal a new quest card. Okay. As long. Jeez. Okay, not too bad. I guess. Okay, so we're up against 2, 4, 6, 9, 14. So we do 10 progress. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Look at that.
Hey.
And we're just making the nameless sphere angrier. Goes here. Jeez. Okay. Do you want to engage anybody optionally?
Well, will it take enough heat off of you if I take them both? Because I can just do undefended attacks all day since this is my last turn. Hopefully I'll take some down with me.
Sure.
I'll optionally engage one, then the other one comes down naturally. Oh, yeah, the Goblin Swarm. Are there really that many Spearmen in the deck?
Yeah, yeah.
We have all the Spearmen.
Somebody had made a custom quest. He took like all the orcs and goblins from the Mirkwood cycle and Khazad Dûm and made a crazy encounter deck with it, where it's
crazy
just like
orc swarm.
Yeah, orc swarm madness, and it was really fun.
Fair enough.
So that was you, first player. 1, 2, 3.
All right.
Okay. Knock yourself out. Literally.
We'll do Dwalin against I don't know, pick one. Sure.
I'm glad that guy's gone.
Okay. I will exhaust this guy and raise my threat by and spend a resource to ready Biffer. And Biffer will defend the next guy.
I drew a card. There you go. Nothing.
Okay. 2 damage, 2 defense. Nothing happens. My Miner of the Iron Hills will defend the next one.
He is dead.
Okay, so he is more dead.
Oops. Is that a word, deader?
Deader. Yep, sure, we'll go with it. 2 left, huh? I'm really only going to be able to take 1 down anyway. All right, Dane will go the next one.
Nothing.
Okay.
Nada. Damage.
And undefended. Okay, so he's 6. I guess we'll put him on Owen. All right. Here you go.
She's dead. There's really no point saving up anybody for anything, so.
Hey now.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And. Whoops. Nothing.
All right.
Counterattacks.
Let's smash one of them into paste. Quazo, I'm not defending with the Hammersmith because it's moot. Because Owen couldn't have killed any of them, and the Hammersmith now can't kill any of them. But I still will attack to show, you know, his final effort. It just does no damage.
All right. Well, farewell, my friend.
Refresh. Ah! Not the player
In
token.
the world of Lord of the Rings card game, it's like dividing by zero. That's 50 threat. Yeah, there's really not much I can do here. Look what I just drew.
That is
I put it
insulting.
in there just in case. Yeah, I'll give up. And I don't think anybody's gonna blame me. Well played.
Well, guys, this shows you never to get cocky. My Dwarf Swarm deck is probably probably the one I consider my probably all-around strongest. And you can still get your ass handed to you. So a 166 loss, is that a good loss or is that a bad loss?
I don't think a loss means anything because actually Thorin should have been dead as well. Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks for sticking around, guys. I'm glad you joined us. It was a little awkward without Brandon and Brian bickering in the background. I don't know about you guys. I kind of missed it a little bit.
I did my
But
best to cover that base. I'm not as good.
I love you a 10, but you're no Brandon.
I know.
Nor am I a Brian. But anyway, that's it for tonight. I believe next week we're still planning on sticking to our normal schedule. And yes, the dwarves were outswarmed. Well put, Aquazo. So hopefully next week, I don't know what we're going to be playing at this point. Like I said, I think our goal is to actually have Ian come on and Dungeon Master for us the next time we try his first age quest. If it looks like that's not going to happen in the near future, we'll probably just soldier on without him and maybe revisit later. But anyway, to return to my original point, we're going to be recording an audio podcast later this week, so look for that coming out hopefully pretty soon. Also, celebrate with us, guys. We're getting our next adventure pack. It looks like the official release date for it is Thursday, so hallelujah. New cycle starts. Etienne, anything to add before we
No, it was good to be back on Twitch. It's been a little while, but looking forward to the next one. Thanks, guys, for showing up. We started a little later, but there seems to be quite a few people still showed up. So, yeah.
Absolutely. All right. Well, thanks for joining us, guys. Good night, Twitch, and good night, YouTube. Or good morning, YouTube. Whatever it happens to be. It's the luxury of on-demand video viewing.